A judge in Donald Trump's civil fraud trial denied a motion by Trump's lawyers to throw out the case and declare a mistrial. Meanwhile, Trump and his legal team are preparing for the very real possibility that he will be on trial for various criminal charges throughout the entirety of the 2024 general election. For more on this, it's time for a closer look. The numbers for Joe Biden have been bad recently. For example, today was his birthday and he turned 81, despite hopes from his inner circle that they could keep the number in the mid to low 70s. Yeah, 81, that can't be right. Let's count on my birthdays one more time. All right, there was that one in Scranton. There was another one in Scranton. This is gonna be bad, guys. On the one hand, Democrats have been on a winning streak when it comes to actual elections, everywhere from Kentucky to Ohio to Virginia. But on the other hand, polls continue to suggest that voters aren't exactly thrilled with Joe Biden right now. Again, we're a year away from the election, so none of this is predictive. But this weekend, yet another poll showed Trump leading Biden in a hypothetical matchup.
If we are heading towards Trump, Biden, a rematch in 2024, how does that look in our polling right now? Here it is. Wow. Donald Trump, we have at 46%. Biden, 44.
And this is significant because this is the first time in the history of our poll that former President Trump beats President Biden, still within the margin of error, but still significant.
Yeah, in 2019, 2020, when Trump was president, he trailed all of them. This year, he's trailed all of them in our poll. First time in more than a dozen polls we've seen a result like this.
You know what? I'm not panicking. I'm staying calm, cool, confident, collected. That's just the new me, the new Seth. I don't wear a suit. I don't cut my hair. I don't freak out about polls a full year before the election. Sure. In years past, I might have been up all night popping Xanax, biting my fingernails down to the bone, and replying to those "we need your help" fundraising emails with my own all caps "you need to focus on Michigan" emails. But that's not the new me. I'm not worried about the possibility of a second term for Donald Trump, a twice impeached wannabe dictator who's orchestrated a coup attempt, is facing four indictments, calls his political opponents Vernons, and dances like a dad at a SZA concert. Well, I mean, of course Biden looks old next to Kid Boogie. I'm not worried about any of the polling because it's a year out and I'm above all that. The other reason I'm not worried is that if Trump does win, I have a go bag so I can get the out of here. I got my passport, a change of clothes, $10,000 in cash, and a webcam so I can do the show from a country that won't extradite to the U.S. I keep it right here under my desk in the studio because I trust my crew not to take any of my money, and my money's gone. Who sold my escape money? Was it you, Wally?
Yeah, hold on. Buy me 20,000 shares of Tesla, yeah, the new Bugatti, and meet me at Per Se for dinner. I'm sorry, Seth. What's that?
Well, it was only $10,000 in the bag, Wally.
Hold on one second. Buy me one share of Tesla, a used Honda Accord, and meet me at Sparrow's.
Wally! I think historically, go bags don't have your name on them. So Trump is yet again pulling ahead of Biden in a hypothetical matchup. Again, we're a year away, and this has happened before. Barack Obama trailed Mitt Romney in some polls before the 2012 election. Of course, Mitt Romney hadn't already been a terrible president who stoked an insurrection. Oh, that's the old Seth creeping in there again. Right now, the big problem Biden is facing is frustration from within his own party.
If you take a look here by party, I think it's significant for two reasons. One, independents, obviously, more than 2-1 disapprove. You don't want to be there as an incumbent president. But I think equally significant, no surprise, 7% of Republicans approve of Joe Biden's job performance, but three times as many Democrats, 21%, that's more than 1 in 5, say they disapprove. You need much more unified support in your own party.
That's right, 21% of Democrats disapprove of Biden, and that's the difference. Trump doesn't have the same problem with his base. He could renounce literally every position he's ever held, call himself a woke Antifa communist who believes the military should be abolished, and everyone should live together on one giant hippie commune where they smoke weed and wear Hawaiian shirts, and his supporters would say, hell yeah, let's call it Margaritaville, baby. They're not going to Trump rallies to hear him talk policy. They're going to hear him talk about windmills and celebrities and do B-minus jokes while he sweats through his suit. It's the wet collar comedy tour. They go for the same reason you go see Billy Joel. I don't want to hear anything new. I just want to listen to a grumpy old man for 3 hours. To be honest, I'm not sure there's ever been a Democratic president Democratic voters haven't at some point been annoyed at, except for Barack Obama. It doesn't matter what he did. Democrats loved him. He could compromise on health care or spending cuts or whatever, but all he had to do was sink a three or drink something out of a coconut with his shirt unbuttoned, and we'd all be like, 12 more years! Looking back, we could have been a little more chill. Biden obviously does not have the same base level of goodwill with his own party, and now he's desperately trying to calm down nervous Democrats. According to the Washington Post, the Biden campaign has been working to ease Democratic anxiety over his re-election chances, with one Biden fundraiser telling the paper, the bad news is that everybody is wetting the bed inside the Biden world. It's really an unhappy confluence of Biden world donors, cocktail party friends saying, can't you get him not to run? Which is stupid and absurd if you know Joe Biden. First of all, it's ridiculous to say everybody inside Biden world is wetting the bed. Some of us outside Biden world are wetting the bed, too. I don't know if you guys watch this show, but I have on several occasions said some unflattering things about Trump, and he doesn't give off strong water under the bridge vibes. Not many dictators come to power and then say, this has fixed the hole deep inside me, and I no longer feel the need to exact revenge on my detractors. Have a nice day. Second, of course, Joe Biden's not going to drop out. Dude's 81, he still rides a bike. He wears aviators, for God's sakes. If he wore those glaucoma glasses, sure, you might be able to get him to step aside. But aviators? The official sunglasses? The hotshots who don't play by the rules? I don't think so. Of course, ultimately, when the time comes, Biden will be running against Donald Trump, a man who left office with the lowest approval rating in the history of polling, and who has repeatedly tanked the GOP in every election since 2018. And not only that, Trump will likely be on trial in multiple jurisdictions throughout the entirety of the general election.
Do you think any of these cases are going to go to trial before the election?
I do. I think that something has happened in the last couple of hours. One is that Fannie Willis in Fulton County, Georgia, has asked for the trial to be set, I believe, on August 5th in that case. I do think that the federal trial on election subversion charges is going to happen in March or April at the latest, and I think we will see several months of a trial. I don't think people have quite gotten their heads around what it's going to look like when there is the potentially the presumptive frontrunner for the Republican nomination sitting in a courtroom every day. You have to attend as a criminal.
Yeah, in March or April.
In March or April for many, many weeks. That would basically mean Trump is on trial the entire general election, and that's an astonishing thing to get your head around.
Yeah, none of us have fully processed that yet. One of the two major party candidates for president will be sitting in a courtroom every day for virtually the entire general election. I'm betting that's not exactly what the founding fathers had in mind when they set up our political system. It was so beyond their imagination, they didn't even think to put a clause in the Constitution that says you can't run for president if you have boxes of classified documents sitting in your cheesy fake marble bathroom, you dingus. And we've already seen Trump in court for his civil fraud trial in New York. He doesn't handle it well. He sits there scowling all day like a jungle cat in a local zoo. And I'm not talking some fancy wildlife conservation site like San Diego or the Bronx. I'm talking about a podunk zoo in central Jersey where kids take school trips and they just pound on the glass. That's what Trump looks like. He looks like a caged tiger just sitting there thinking, if I was 10 years younger and this was the rainforest, you'd all be lunch. In fact, Trump is so mad about this case that he filed a truly ridiculous motion for a mistrial, claiming the judge and the clerk were biased against him. But the judge quickly shot it down.
The judge overseeing Trump's civil fraud trial in New York rejected the former president's motion for a mistrial. On Friday, Judge Arthur Engoron said the motion is, quote, utterly without merit. Trump had claimed the judge and his principal law clerk are biased against him.
There isn't a lot of proof that the conversations between the judge and his law clerk are, in fact, emblematic of bias. Just because you lose repeatedly in front of a judge doesn't mean that judge is biased.
Trump can't get that simple fact through his brain. Maybe you could claim bias once or twice, but you can't claim bias literally every time you ever lose anything anywhere, especially when you make crazy requests that any judge would rule against. Like when Trump was on the stand, and hours into his testimony, he attempted to read from a mysterious piece of paper he retrieved from his pocket, claiming it would prove his innocence. Here's the deal, man. If it never happened on an episode of Law & Order, you can't do it. So Trump just claims anytime he loses anything, it's because everyone is biased against him. He's like the kid you played video games with in middle school who would insist the only reason you beat him at FIFA was because his controller was broken. It keeps saying it even though you've given him like 20 different controllers. All these controllers, they're biased against me. The buttons are too small for my giant thumbs. I went to GameStop and a guy came up to me, big guy, bearded guy, tears pouring down his face onto his Fortnite t-shirt. And he said, sir, I'm sorry Xbox is biased against you. That's why now I get all my games from the pro-Trump gaming console, Xbox. Trump specifically argued that the clerk was biased against him and was somehow colluding with the judge. Trump's lawyers accused the clerk, who sits alongside the judge in the courtroom, of improperly acting as a co-judge in the case, to which the actual judge replied, such arguments are nonsensical. My principal, a law clerk, does not make rulings or issue orders, I do. That's obviously insane. If Trump thinks the judge has some secret plan to have his clerk co-judge, the clerk probably wouldn't set right next to him. Now remember, we're secretly gonna conspire with each other to deny the defendant his rights, but everything has to be very hush-hush. Understood. Where should I sit?
I think right next to me. To make the whispering easier. I mean, let's not make this harder than we have to.
We know one thing for sure about the 2024 election. It's gonna be close. Trump may very well win. But in the meantime, he'll be on trial, and he could even be convicted before the polls open, which means instead of attending his election night party as a candidate, he'd have to
pretend as a criminal.
This has been A Closer Look. Hey, everybody. Thanks for watching A Closer Look. And as a reminder, my brother Josh and I have started a new podcast called Family Trips with the Meyers Brothers. We hope you listen. We hope you like it. And see you soon.